Hey there, YouTubers. Just making a video here. There's anybody who knows how to set the jumper settings properly on this hard drive, or any hard drive, I need it done because I want to use this as a spare. It's 80 gigabyte hard drive. My current one is 80 gigabyte, and it only has like 35 left, and I want more, so. I've tried all the settings and I can't get it to properly set because every time I put it in there it wants to boot from that hard drive, which has a failing attribute, so I cannot use it to boot with. That's why I need to put it in there, use it as a spare so I can format it and use it for storage. So if there's anyone out there who knows how to do it, please comment on the video and let me know. It is currently in jumper setting 5 and 6. If you know if there's any computer geeks out there, they know how to do it. I mean, I'm a computer geek, but I just don't know how to do it. So if you can do it for me, please subscribe or even comment. That's pretty much it. I got a few projects here I'm working on for now. I got a nice IBM laptop here. Missing hard drive for now. A replacement is actually $106. Fair price, but not a good one if you don't have the money. I just wanted to show you something cool on it real quick. If you'll let me boot it up or turn it on. It won't boot up, obviously, because of no hard drive. But a familiar thing with this model here is a keyboard flashlight, as you would say. It's very interesting. Wait on it to enter the setup utility. That's the only place it'll actually light up the light, since there's no hard drive or operating system to boot from. And I know my webcam is terrible, so bear with me on that. I'm not sure how to get it to move in sync. If there's anyone out there who knows how to do that too, please tell me. You can see that, and I'm sure you can read it because I can read it from my screen. IBM ThinkPad, if you can see on the bottom here, it's a message saying there's no hard drive found. Top of the screen here, right here, that's a keyboard light. If you're working in the dark, the light shines straight down on the keyboard. You can see on it, it's actually pretty cool. But yeah, that's kind of it for now. I can show you where the hard drive goes on this thing. See, you can see where I'm peeling the tape off. Those are the audio jacks, speakers, audio in, and microphone. Now, this thing, just slide it on here, basically. And stupid me thought the screw goes back in the computer, like it is. Well, I was wrong completely. Anyway, see, this piece just comes off, and right in this space slides the Smart IDE 20 gigabyte hard drive. Now I know 20 gigabytes is not bad, is not a lot. You got 1 terabyte, 3 terabyte, going on 5 now. But right now I guess that at that point in time this is a 2003 laptop actually. For 2003, 20 gigabytes is a lot, so I mean, you can't argue with that. And for me, I think 80 gigs is a lot too. But this thing is just held on by tape for now until I can gather up $106 to get the new hard drive. So anyway, yeah, this is the IBM laptop for now. Let's see, I got. Another project here I'm working on. Maybe not. You can see that printer right there. That is a little thing I like to call garbage. It doesn't work. I'll show you the printer / scanner that does work. I'm not using it as a printer, but that's my monitor you're seeing right here. This here, Epson scanner printer, that's good for now, I guess. I haven't really made any videos for YouTube, really, where I'm actually talking or anything, except for CCleaner and this one, really. So I'm just trying to get a feel for it. Using a webcam recording software that actually has multiple formats. This one I actually chose the YouTube format, so should work pretty good on there. I'm not sure, but can't beat that. Anyway, about the hard drive and the clarity on the webcam, if there's anybody out there who knows how to do it, please subscribe. Thanks, and I hope to have more upcoming videos on computer fixes,